Hey everyone, welcome to Cricut Time. If you like this video, subscribe for more project ideas and tutorials on all things Cricut. Hey everyone, today I'll show you how to add flourishes to your writing in Cricut Design Space. Adding these fun accents can really step up your projects, and it's super simple to do. The key to adding these accents is in your font choice. These accents are called glyphs, and not all fonts have the fun flourishes built in, but there are lots that do. I'll show you how to find out which ones do and how to access them. Today's tutorial is for an iPad or an iPhone. If you're using a computer, just click on one of these links instead to switch over to the tutorials for a Mac or a PC. There are lots of great fonts in Design Space, but unfortunately, they do not come with any accents or flourishes. You'll need to download a new font to make this work. To do this, we need to download two apps. Head to your App Store, and the first program to download is called iFont. This app is free and will allow you to download different fonts. Let's start by opening this one up. Down on the bottom, click on Font Finder. There are a few good options here where you can download your fonts from. Today I'll go with defont.com. If you haven't used Defont before, there are lots of fonts to choose from. You can find fonts in almost any style you can think of. There are categories at the top to make the fonts easier to find. The category I would recommend checking out is under Script, right here, Calligraphy. There are lots of fonts in this category that have nice glyphs. There are lots of styles that have these pretty little tails, like Adelia. There are also a few that have hearts to connect words, like on Hello Honey and Joseph Sophia. Hello is also a good option. Look through and find styles that you like. I have included the names of a few of my favorite fonts in the description below to help you get started. Find one that you want to use for your project. Let's go with Hello Honey, then click on Download. Click on Import, then click on Install. I'll just click on Allow and close this. Now it's on your phone or iPad, but you still need to do an extra step to access it. The app will walk you through the steps, but you need to go into your settings, click on General, and then click on VPN and Device Management. Click on the font that you downloaded, and then click on Install. Click on Install one more time, and then it will be good to use. The font is installed on your phone or iPad now, but in order to use it in Cricut Design Space, we need to download one more app as well. I'll go back into the App Store, and the last app I need to download is called Unicode. This one isn't free, but it's only a dollar, and it is key to making the glyphs work in Design Space, so it's well worth it for me. Open it up and click on Browse Fonts. As you can see here, it has all of your fonts that are on your iPad or iPhone compiled into one convenient location. Let's click on the one we just installed, Hello Honey. Every glyph and character that each font has will be shown in this list. As I scroll down, you can see that all of the standard letters are here, but when I keep scrolling, there are three other special sets of letters that have flourishes attached to them as well. There is this cute set with the hearts, and then there are flourishes in front and behind each letter as well. Now that everything is downloaded, we can do the fun part, playing with your new flourishes and accents in Cricut Design Space. Start out by clicking on Text. Now let's change the font. Up on the top, you will see that the fonts are broken into headings. The Cricut-based fonts are in the first category. You will find yours in the second category, System. Click on that, and you can search the font you're looking for up here. If you try to find your new font, but you don't see it, just close the Design Space app and reopen it again. Now I can put my writing in. I'll keep it simple today and put in Welcome. Let's spruce it up by changing the W to one with a nice glyph. Just go back into the Unicode app and find the character you want to use. I want this W, so I'll just tap on it, then tap on this little up arrow at the top to share, and tap on Share Glyph. Now I can tap on Copy and go back into Design Space. I'll tap back on the writing, press and hold, and then tap on Paste. I'll repeat the same process with the E. I'll go back into Unicode, find the E I want, tap on the arrow, tap on Share Glyph, copy, go back into Design Space, and paste this E into position. This looks great. I'll show you one more really popular way to use glyphs as well. I'll just bring in another text box and change my font to Hello Honey. For this one, I want to show you how to use the heart glyphs. These are really popular for signs and weddings. I'll go with Jack and Sally for today's tutorial. I'll just start by bringing in the J from Unicode, tap on the arrow, share glyph, copy, go back into Design Space, and paste the J. I'll put in the rest of Jack, and then I can connect Jack with Sally using a heart in the middle. There are quite a few fonts with these cute little hearts to connect words. You use these the exact same way. I'll tap on this K, share, share glyph, copy, and paste it in. Now I can just finish it off by repeating this process and bringing in the Y. Before you go and give this a try, there is one more thing I need to tell you. The font that you copied and pasted from Unicode needs to be the same font that you're using in Design Space. If you forget, which will likely happen at some point, it will look like this. You will go to Paste, and nothing will show up. I'll try again and put it in a new spot. And this time there is a big space, but you still can't see the glyph. It actually is still there, but in order to see it, you need to go down and change your font to the right one. Once you do that, you'll be able to see all the letters again. Well, there you have it. Now you can add flourishes and accents to your writing like a pro. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe for more project ideas and tutorials on all things Cricut. Also, if you have a favorite font with flourishes, drop it in the comments below. I would love to check it out.